Upon arrival to Puerto Vallarta, we were greeted with rain, humid, and gloomy weather. But the upside was that our airport shuttle came with free beers. The driver's name was Sabio. He was very friendly and helpful. He gave us a brief history of Puerto Vallarta, recommendations and stories of a local area. Very, very friendly guy. Very, very helpful and very nice. He had some good tips. We stayed at the Grand Fiesta Americana. This was my first resort, so I'm not sure how it compares to other resorts. But it seems like your very standard all-inclusive Mexican resort. It's very nice, very spacious. The people were very friendly. The service was pretty good. It was very relaxing and soothing to just sit on the balcony and just stare out into the ocean. This is something that I didn't anticipate would be a big priority for me, but when we were there, it actually changed my mind about having a private beach. There are a bunch of lounges and restaurants in the resort.
Crab is dead. No. Where's the rest of it?
And there was also a rooftop bar, which is also a nightclub during the evening. And I think most of us spent majority of our nights there.
Suavecito para arriba, para arriba, para arriba. Sensual.
The resort food was typical of any all-inclusive resort food. Food wasn't bad. There was a variety of food, from steak to Italian to Asian, which included, surprisingly, sushi. And of course, there was your standard breakfast buffet that we had every morning. But the more important thing was that we ate as a group, and when you eat with your friends, the food is always better. We head downtown to the Malecón Boardwalk, which is a boardwalk where you can walk down a very short distance with the ocean on one side and shops on the other side. There are plenty of restaurants and bars and tiny shops. This is the club that our driver recommended. It's supposed to be popping. Another part of the downtown area is a neighborhood called Zona Romántica. And that was actually one of my favorite spots. It was more of a quaint little neighborhood with little mom and pop shops.
Thinking it was a tostada. What is it, tostada?
Yeah.
And for a taco.
We ate at a few restaurants down there. The people at the restaurants were very nice. We spoke to some of the owners that recommended other places to eat at, which turned out to be their own restaurant. But nonetheless, they were all very hospitable and welcoming, and they spoke really good English, which actually helped us a lot. For me, I enjoyed the food, especially the churros. For our all-group dinner, we went to this restaurant called The Happy Lobster. It was known for fresh seafood and a great and fun atmosphere, and that did not disappoint. Dexter somehow got really drunk and knocked out during the meal. A lot of us ordered and shared chef's platter, which included lobster, giant prawns, and shrimp. Food was amazing. The servers were comedic. Everything I had was really good. Since it was my birthday, the restaurant celebrated by giving us tons and tons of shots and then had me participate in embarrassing shenanigans. I had to wear an apron, which had a penis under it, and a hat.
La gente la mira y le empieza a gritar. Bravo, bravo, Chona, nadie te puede
some random dude came and tried to grind up on me. It was a lot of fun, it was embarrassing, and the workers totally made it a more enjoyable experience. So for the girls' bachelorette party, I'm just going off of what Carolyn told me. They went ATVing, and afterwards they went to the spa, which they claim they've gotten the best massage of their life, and I don't doubt that. And then they had other things planned, such as dinners and games. Which looked like they had a more crazy night than the guys did. For the bachelor party, the guys planned everything and didn't tell me what was going on. But we met up early. First thing we went to was to the company. And our first excursion was ATVing. This was my first time, and actually all of our first time doing this, so it was a new experience, and it was actually really fun, and it was actually really, really scenic. Our second excursion was zip lining, but I don't have any clips from that because we didn't have our stuff. That was tough because we actually had to hike all the way up the mountain to zip line, and we were not prepared for that. We were out of breath after every station, but still enjoyable nonetheless. And our final excursion was mule riding, which was us riding mules back to our starting point. That was probably the most nervous event of the day because some of the mules went crazy. And it was, since we were on the side of a cliff, had one mule pushed another mule off, we would have went down with it. But we made it, so that was cool. After all of our stuff, we were exhausted and just hung out at the restaurant, ordered some appetizers and drinks, and just take in the scenery that was around us. And before we left, we actually got a tequila tasting, which was really good, and it made us appreciate really good tequila.
Esta es la chica sexy. Yeah!
So I think that's all for the trip. I loved it a lot. I got a good balance of adventure, fun, and relaxing. The beach was amazing, and the people were great. I'm just glad I got to experience with everyone who was there with us. So to end this video, I'll just leave a bunch of dancing clips because we did a ton of that. All right, thanks for watching.
La chica se mueve rico, esa esa chica nació con ritmo. Y la chica se mueve sexy, y la chica se mueve rico. Esa chica se mueve suave, esa chica inventó este ritmo. Se mueve sexy y la chica se mueve rico. Esa chica se mueve suave, esa chica me para el ritmo. Y la chica se mueve sexy y la chica se mueve rico. Esa chica se mueve suave, esa chica me sube el ritmo. Y la chica se mueve sexy y la chica se mueve rico. Esa chica se mueve suave, esa chica nació con ritmo. Y la chica se mueve sexy y la chica se mueve rico. Esa chica se mueve suave, esa chica inventó este ritmo. Tubo, tubo, ea, ea. Chica.